Hi guys, back Paul here. Short little video today then. Just wanted to bring you a review of some RST textile jeans that I bought recently. So at this time of year, obviously the weather's pretty poor. It's not really kind of weather where you're going to be wearing a two-piece or one-piece leather suit on your bike. And I had to upgrade my textile, so my old ones were getting pretty worn. I had them quite a long time, and I bought these particular ones from Sports Bike Shop. So if you're familiar with my channel, you've probably seen quite a lot of my videos where I bought kit online, and usually I tend to use Sports Bike Shop just because they have a kind of vast range and good pricing and so on. But as I've tested these quite a bit, I wanted to give you my opinion on them, and thought it might be interesting because there's a huge range now of textile jackets and jeans, and sometimes it can be difficult to kind of pick out the right ones. And even if you look on their website, they kind of start from 50 odd pound and they go all the way up, you know, into the hundreds. I tend to go for RST because they're normally a pretty good brand. In terms of the material then, RST state it's a three layer soft shell fabric which is both waterproof and breathable. This is an image from the inside of the jeans, just kind of like a little tag explaining the features and the material and how that works. I've been out in them in the wet weather, not in torrential rain, but where it has rained fairly heavy, and so far, touch wood, they have been waterproof. You know, that's a claim that a lot of manufacturers will make. Sometimes you actually realize that they're not that waterproof when you actually come to wear them, but so far these have been excellent. There are, like I said, several features as well as part of these trousers. So as you'd expect, they've got knee protection. So it's CE approved knee protection. There's also pockets in the hips for hip protection if you want to kind of purchase that separately. The knee protection is pretty good. It doesn't get in the way. Sometimes with bike jeans, as you may well know, it can kind of ride higher up than your knee, or sometimes it's kind of positioned too low. These seem to be about just right, and I only purchased these just based on my usual size for jeans, so I didn't you know, actually go and try them on or anything like that. I just bought them online. They've got a waterproof liner. I'll also show you kind of the thermal liner that you take out, although it's been pretty cold. I've just been wearing these with a base layer underneath. I've got another video on my channel, so I'll put a link to that as like a pinned comment underneath this video or in the description to my other video, which is the RST leather jacket in jeans, and that's also got the base layers. You can wear the thermal lining that comes with these trousers. Obviously, it's just personal preference, but I tend to find just the base layer under these is perfectly fine, even when it's quite cold. If it was, you know, really freezing, then yeah, you'd probably go for the kind of thermal layer. So there's several stretch panels on these. So you've got these ones that you can see just above the arm on the knee. There's this at the back here, and then you've got this just there. And there's also a connecting zip, as you'd expect, so you can connect that to an RST jacket. These are pretty good. These parts just here, so they're Velcro, but they're also excellent at just to kind of getting the fit right. Depending on the brand, they all have different methods. Some are just literally a button, but I think kind of old school Velcro seems to work best, and so you can get that nice and adjusted. These reflective details, so you see these RST logos. Although these are just plain black, you know, there's nothing fancy in terms of colours or anything, it just fits in with the other kit and my bike, so I don't go too outrageous with colours or anything like that. But they've got the reflective logos on, so at least I'll pick up in the headlights on, you know, cars and vehicles and so on. And what I tend to go for when I'm buying kit like this is mainly the review. So at Sports Bike Shop, these are rated at a 4.5 star rating, and I think that's important because you can look at the manufacturer's kind of blurb on products and they'll obviously tell you all the best points, but until you're using them and until you've got an idea of how they feel when you're wearing them and how comfortable they are and so on, it's difficult to say, you know, how good they are. And with the reviews on Sports Bike Shop, there's quite a lot of reviews for these, and in general RST kit is usually highly rated. The bottom of the jeans then, you've got a Velcro fastening and a zip. Nothing fancy, just functional, but means you can adjust it and get the fit right whether you're going to be wearing these inside your boots or over the top of them. And RST state that all the zips are max zips on these. The material is heavy duty thread and everything's triple stitched. Overall, they do seem good quality. I've not had any issues with them so far. Nothing's frayed in terms of the Velcro and the fabric. All the zips have worked fine and the material seems strong, although they are comfortable as well. We've got a couple of pockets up at the top. This is a thermal lining then. Nothing, again, too extravagant, just functional. Nice and thick though, good quality material. You can see the zips just there, so they just zip to the trousers. And yeah, well made. I've not had a need to use them yet, but I'd expect that, you know, in cold weather or when it's really, really freezing, they might be handy and just good quality overall. There is also another pair of jeans that I spotted on the website by RST, just a little bit more price-wise than these. They were £119.99 and they are basically a mixture of leather and textile, so it might be worth checking those out. I'll put a link below this video. Well, yeah, hopefully you found this video useful. As always, thank you to those who've subscribed to my channel. If you've got any questions or comments on these, then just ask away. And if you're not familiar with my channel, or if this is the kind of the first video that you've watched, I tend to put out a mixture of videos, really. So some are based on kit that I buy for the bike, you know, textiles, leathers, helmets and so on, accessories for my own bike, which is a Yamaha MT-09. I've got a few videos on that bike on my channel as well. But also, I've started taking out more recently bikes for test rides and reviews, so do some vlogs on those. So, yeah. If you've not yet done so, please subscribe and we'll put some more videos out soon.